Hello, everyone. In this two-part video, we'll look at patent citations, backward and forward. In this first part, we'll begin with backward citations. When a patent application is filed, the applicant or the patent examiner may cite prior art, including older patents or non-patent literature, together sometimes known as the backward citations. Then, once a patent is granted, it may be cited as prior art in later patents or alluded to in later scholarly journals or other articles, and these we call forward citations. And you can search for all of these documents, patent and non-patent, on Dialog. In this video, we'll look at cited patents and cited literature. And for each of these, we'll see first how to view a list of those citations and then how to obtain the records for those cited documents. So let's get started. We'll begin with this 1987 patent, US 4681893, which is the basic patent for the cholesterol-lowering drug known as Lipitor. To view the cited patents, we just do a search for this patent number. Since it's a US patent, I'll use US patents full text. Once we have the record, we go to the Citations tab, and here we see the list of cited patents. So it's just that simple to identify the cited patents by number. Next, if we want to see what is in these cited patents and possibly download them, there are two ways to do this. You can just click on any of these numbers and that runs a search across all of our patent databases. Notice we're still in only US patents full text, but we're also getting results from IFI claims and IMPADOC, as well as two Derwent databases. You can use Quick View or Preview to see a little more. You can click the title from any database that you prefer to see the record. You can download it if you want. And when you're done, you would click here on Back to My Previous Document to return to the list of cited patents, where you can do the same with any of the other cited patents. Now, this method is certainly easy, and it gives you the option to pick any database for the records as you go along. But it does have to be done one record at a time, so you might instead want to create a set that includes all of these cited patents so you can work with them all at once. To do that, you would search for US 4681893 as a citing patent. That would be the CGPN field. First, take a quick look at the list of cited patents and notice where they're from, because that will tell you where to search for them. If you have a variety of sources, like some from the US and others from EP or WO or China, then you would go into the full text patent databases for those countries to run your CGPN search. Or what I like to do is use a custom database shortcut to go into all 31 of the full text patent databases. You can create a database shortcut by going to Preferences and then to the Database Shortcuts tab. But in this case, all of the cited patents are from the US, and we're already in US patents full text, so I can just go back to my original PN search and change it to a CGPN search. I run that, and now I have a new set that contains the records for all of the patents where US 4681893 is a citing patent, which in other words is a set of all the patents that are cited by that patent. We should get 7 hits, and here they are. We can browse these results, preview them, use Quick, click on the titles, or we could just go ahead and download any or all of them. So we've looked at both ways to get the cited patent records. The other type of backward citation is cited literature. So let's go back to the original record, and here on the Citations tab, right under Cited Patents, you'll find the Cited Literature. This one has 5 cited articles, and to get these records, there's actually a tip right here to remind you how to do it. It says to use the Lookup Citation search form to find these documents after selecting all databases. That would be the general databases, not the patent databases. So I'll walk us through getting 2 of them. But any that you want to get, you might first want to take a screen capture of this list or print it so you can refer to it. I usually just make a few notes on paper to identify the articles. I'll go into all of the general databases, and then to access the lookup citations form, I'll hover over Advanced Search, and from the little pop-up, click Lookup Citations. And on the Lookup Citations form, I just put in some of the identifiers for each record in these little boxes. I have some written notes, but for this video, I'll put a little image of the cited literature on the screen so you can see it. And for the first one, I'll just fill in Singer as the author, the volume as 102, the start page as 370, and the year 1959. The citation doesn't give us the title of the article, but that's often the case in patent records, and we won't need it. And I could put in the journal name, but when I click search, I find the few boxes that I filled in were enough to get this record from Medline. Let's do the third one here. I fill in Brown as the author, the volume number 305, the start page 515, and the year 1981. And again, that's all we needed to get the record. This one is from the New England Journal of Medicine, which we actually have as a full-text database. So I can just click here, and now I have the whole cited article. Before we wrap up, let's review database choices. For demonstration, I was using a U.S. patent, so I began in U.S. patents full text, or I could have used IFI claims. If the patent was from some other country, I would have used the full text patent database for the country or authority that issued the patent. Or I could have used IMPADOC, which covers over 100 countries, to search for the patent, find the cited patents list, and click on each one. But it's important to note that if I want to create a set of all the cited patents by using a citing patent or CGPN search, as we saw, then that is something you cannot do in IMPADOC, because IMPADOC doesn't have a CGPN field. So for the CGPN search, to create a set of all the cited patents, you want to go into the full text databases for all of the cited patents that you're looking for. The other relevant database is Derwent Patents Citation Index, which works a bit differently. This is the Derwent Patents Citation Index record for US 4681893, and the main difference from the other records we've seen is that it groups patent citations together by patent family. It uses the same patent family groups as Derwent World Patents Index, so that DWPI gives you the abstracts, while DPCI is a sort of counterpart for just the citation information. This record gives you the cited patent and cited literature, not just for 4681893, but also for the other members of that patent family. This database covers about 20 countries and patenting authorities. For more information about the Derwent Patent Citation Index, I would urge you to check out the pro sheet for this database, especially if you would like to work with citation information by family groups. So that's it. By using patent citations, you can begin by finding even just one patent that is somewhat close to the kind of invention you're looking for, and from the citations, you can reach forward and backward in time across the development of an idea and find everything that has grown out of it to gain a much broader understanding of the technology and what is out there. And in part two of this video, we'll look at forward citations. If you'd like more information, here are some links to additional resources, and if you have any questions or would like some help, feel free to call the help desk at these numbers or email us at customer@dialogue.com. Thanks for using Dialogue, and enjoy the rest of your day.